Okay. Let's have everybody make sure that you stay behind her, because she can't see behind her, and stay down, low to the ground, so that we don't, freak her out at all. Even though she's kind of in her trance, because she's dropping eggs right now. So she's used those hind flippers that are kind of like hands inside of oven mitts, and she's digged herself out an egg chamber.
You guys have a red light?
Yes, we do.
All right.
And, cool. Who's got a red headlamp to hand me?
I do.
There.
A what?
Red. It's got a red on it. One click should give you red.
Cool. Okay. So, one of the other neat things about this animal is that she's covered in barnacles, and this is a particular type of barnacles that doesn't exist anywhere else except for on the backs of these particular sea turtles. So the barnacles, what we believe is, a barnacle is not a type of clam or a thing like that. It's a crustacean. It's a type of shrimp. It's basically a shrimp that is glued to a surface and has this casing around it, which is neat. But you can see her hind flippers lift up there.
Can you see any of the bow?
I just thought she's been chewed up a bit on the back end.
Well, that's just kind of her normal shape there that they have at the bottom there.
Do you want to put this one down? You can see it.
Take a second video. Because you're closer.
Oh, no, that's fine. It looks great. But certainly an amazing thing. Here in the middle of the night, unknown to most people, a giant turtle has lurched out of the water and is laying eggs. And I can't tell you how many times I've had people at this moment, when looking at the turtle, say, is it a boy or girl? I promise you she's female.
Can you seriously ask?
So every time those back flippers go up, she's tensing and releasing eggs down into the nest. Ooh, no flash.
The turtle thinks it's lightning. We're okay.
I'll send this video to you. I'll send the video to you.
Oh, post it on Facebook. And this is, loggerheads tend to be a little bit on the small side. The males tend to get more robust. They have real big tails to house their sexual organs, which are giant on turtles. And they tend to be just a bigger animal overall. So females are a little bit, I mean, compared to the other sea turtles, she'd be considered a little on the small side. I mean, certainly a leatherback is much, much, much larger. And looks like a giant tractor trailer has come out of the water. And the green sea turtles take a lot longer to nest. So what will probably happen is she'll go through her nesting cycle. We'll watch her cover up. We'll walk with her behind her as she goes back into the water and wish her well on her way. And then as we're walking back north up the beach, hopefully we'll see the green sea turtle then going back into the water, and we can all kind of stand there giving her a path while she does that, and we'll see just how much larger she is, because that green sea turtle was on the big side. So.
Bunch of people awkwardly watching you scuttle back.
That's right. How'd you like to lay eggs with a crowd watching you?
She's an exhibitionist.
If it entertained everyone, I mean.
What a good one. But anyway, the interesting thing about those barnacles is that if you look at a green sea turtle, it might have a couple barnacles, but nowhere near as many as this one has. Leatherback, almost no barnacles. Hawksbill, almost no barnacles. And the reason is loggerhead sea turtles tend to be kind of lazy. They lay around underneath reef shelves. They lay on the bottom. They're not super active. They don't really have to be. Most of their food items are on the slow side. They're not actively catching fast things or actively grazing.
Those barnacles
so they tend to get more barnacles. And the barnacles are alive. Those barnacles are holding their breath right now while the turtle is out doing its nesting.
You can see them move every time she clenches.
Yep. Yep, you can see them open and close a little bit too.
Oh, that's gross.
And you all can crawl closer. If you want to crawl right here, you can lurch up closer if you want to, Lily. You can move like a turtle. I mean, it's a chance to where she's not gonna stop. I mean, she's aware that there are creatures around her, but once they start dropping eggs, she's, you know, for the most part, pretty hell bent on finishing that.
Do they run into the egg bound issue of other reptiles? In extenuating circumstances.
You know, I don't know because I don't know of any cases to where they've had pregnant females in captivity to where they couldn't complete their nesting cycle. If something had startled her and she decided now is not the right time and she turns around and goes back into the water, essentially what would happen is she'd hang out in the surf and try again later on in the night. Perhaps. But I would think that if anything went wrong internally with the eggs coming out, it would almost certainly be fatal in the animal. Just like other creatures, precisely. But you can see one of the really neat things about her hind flippers is that if you think about the diversity of turtles, you've got tortoises that live on land and you know aren't aquatic at all. You've got sea turtles, of course, which are the extreme end of being aquatic. Please no flash, and those kinds of things. So. But if you look at the difference in the turtle, every one of them has a shell. The shell's different in construction, but what really makes the turtle different is the limbs. The only difference really between a sea turtle and a tortoise is the type of feet it has to make it adapted for moving around. But you can see on this turtle on the hind feet, you know, you really can see that the flipper looks like a hand in a mitt, and that it has, you know, very defined digits inside of there, which they use to dig around. But certainly if you look at a regular turtle, it has individual toes and things like that on it. So just a wonderful adaptation for it to be fully aquatic. So she's laying her eggs, and then she'll abandon them. Turtles aren't parents. Most reptiles are not. Except for birds. Birds are fantastic parents, and birds are reptiles, of course.
I thought alligators were, too.
They defend the nest, and they'll carry the babies down into the water. In the wallowing holes that the babies will live, the female will be there. But once they've been brought to the water and she completes that cycle, she's done defending them. And if they stick around mom and dad, they'll actually turn into food real quick. While the alligators are down in there. But if you were to take a turtle egg and show it to a sea turtle, it wouldn't know what it is. A sea turtle lives its entire life never seeing sea turtle eggs because the animal can't see behind it. It's blindly laying them into the nest and it's going to cover them up and never comes in contact with that egg.
So this is purely instinctual?
Purely instinctual, absolutely, Berto. So in a few months, you'll have the babies hatch. They don't actually climb upwards. They writhe around inside of the nest after they've hatched, and they make the ceiling cave in on themselves. And then they wiggle around in the sand again, and the ceiling caves in, and the ceiling caves in, and the ceiling caves in, and eventually they're outside.
I don't know if you've noticed all the tracks by ATVs or whatever out here, but there sure are a lot of them.
There are a lot, and those come from our turtle patrol that is out here patrolling turtle harassers and turtles, which is a good thing. It is a good thing because the reason that these animals are so endangered in many cases is because hundreds of turtles would be coming up, and for every turtle that came up, there was a back of a pickup truck to grab the female and toss her into it and take her away and eat her, or use her shell for different types of tortoise rim glasses or things like that. So it's good that we have this level of protection, and in many cases it's necessary to protect these animals and make sure that they're here for another 100 million years. And again, really, the only reason we're able to approach this turtle is because it's not endangered, it's a threatened animal, and really by virtue of the fact that it doesn't taste good and people haven't sought it out for food. And of course, it's hard to see because we're dealing with red light, but her skin's yellowish and brown.
Ochre.
Yep. I'll give you that. Ochre. Great.
Mm-hmm. Must feel so good to live.
From back here at just the right angle, you can
like pooping out in front of you. Back here is just.
Can you see any of the eggs? Yeah, can you see them?
So, how deep do you think that one is?
How deep do I think that is? Oh, probably 24 inches. Sometimes. The female will come up about four times in the season, lay four nests, and then she will not come up for a few years. So each time the egg number gets less, but they'll lay anywhere from 90 to 120 maximum. Okay, so she says, all right, enough of that. And she is now covering her nest. Okay, so what she's going to do now, obviously, is cover up her egg chamber. And then she's going to make an even bigger mess with her front flippers in flipping sand. So if you don't want a face full of sand, you may want to be ready to step back, because that's going to happen in about less than 5 minutes. So, after that, we're all going to kind of part two ways, one group here and one group here, and then we'll let her crawl down back to the ocean in between us. And as she goes back down into the ocean, usually what they've done in years past is you can give her a little pet on her shell, and they have a bioluminescent algae that is symbiotic and lives on their shell, and well, it's not really, it doesn't really, it's not symbiotic, it doesn't do anything for the turtle, but it lives on their shell, and it glows, so that when you touch the turtle with no red lights or anything like that on, we'll turn all of those off for her trip back down to the water, the turtle will glow when you touch it, if it has the algae bacteria on, growing on its shell. But you can see it's just, kind of like, oven mitts. Pat, pat, pat. Scooby. And considering we're about halfway through July, and the fact that we were probably called over right when she started laying her nest, this may be her third or fourth trip up here this season. And this may be it for her. Now she goes back into the ocean, she may come up again.
Hey, Clay.
Yeah.
Say how long the incubation time was for these?
About 90 days.
And then the babies come out generally at night, during the day, or does it matter?
A mixture. Usually very early morning. I feel like they get the instinct to hatch, and I honestly don't know, but I would assume that it's a temperature. Also with the time. Oh, definitely. Yeah, you'll also see nest posting. Turtle researchers will nail a stake into the ground to mark a nest, and they'll put the initials of what kind of turtle it is. A DC is a leatherback, CC is a loggerhead like this one, CM is a green sea turtle, and they'll basically put that post in, usually on the first turtle of the season, the first few turtles on full moons, things like that. They don't mark every nest, because if they did, it would be very difficult to walk around on the beach. Anywhere from 3,000 to 5,000 loggerheads come up on this particular 5-mile stretch of beach. So it is a very active nesting area, which is why I was so confident that we would definitely see one. And we're lucky, well, this is probably not the only turtle we'll see tonight, just on our walk back. Another thing, of course, people have taken lots of photographs, and I'm sure you've seen in documentaries before the turtle crying while it's laying the eggs. And it's before people would think that she's crying because she'll never see her babies again, and that's kind of an intense anthropomorphization of that whole incident. But basically what's going on with that is that this is an animal that drinks the water that it swims around in. All things have to drink water, from fish to whales and dolphins to sea turtles. They drink water just like we do. And in this turtle's case, it's living in salt water and it's drinking salt water. So it has to find a way to get rid of that salt. So it secretes it through a gland in its eye, in the corner of its eye, and it comes out as kind of a thick slurry of very, very salty water coming out of its eye. So normally while the animal's swimming around in the water, you would have no way of seeing that, but it's happening all the time. But when it comes out of the water and goes through this sandy business and it's got all of this sand in its face, it's very easy to see that tear thing going on. Yep, exactly. Now, if something was wrong with this turtle and we'd found it washed up or something like that, or it was hit by a boat and brought to us, and we needed to x-ray it, one of the first things that we would do is take a chisel or a pliers or something like that, usually a chisel because it's the easiest, and a little rubber mallet and knock off those barnacles. And they would come right off, because if you x-ray the animal, the barnacles block out your image of what you're seeing there, because there's such a
dense.
Yeah, they're dense, and they're video dense, exactly. They're not dense per se normally. I mean, some of them can be brittle. These are actually pretty heavy type of barnacles.
Look similar to bone.
You're gonna start making your mess now, sweetheart.
She's almost there. But she's a nice, healthy animal. She's got some meat on her. That's a good thing to see.
She's got nasty meat on her.
I don't see a tag, so she's untagged.
Oh, well, the research center, they wouldn't tag him during this time, would they?
No, sometimes, I mean, they do tag an awful lot of turtles.
But not when they're laying, correct?
Oh, absolutely. We would have definitely tagged her. If we were doing some type
blood
of
samples
study
done, tagging,
or something like that, yeah, we would have absolutely tagged her. We would have just waited. I mean, I've done studies before where we were taking blood samples and putting transmitters on turtles in Melbourne, and we would all sit here waiting for her with a big box that would snap together. And as soon as she turns around to go back into the water, we would all rush her, capture her into the box, take a piece of steel wool, scrub off part of her shell, put PVC glue on it, glue a transmitter onto it, grab the turtle, put it in a bag, weigh it, tag it, take its blood, and then release the poor disoriented animal back into the water, and then track it. After the nesting incident is when you would do that.
Right.
And that's when I mentioned before, and I'd seen one bite someone, they were holding the box to restrain the female. And these turtles can get very large, 150, 180 pounds. And this female turtle that we were dealing with was a particularly big female loggerhead, very much did not want to get caught in a box, was pushing as hard as she could. It took a few people to hold her back, and it grabbed onto this girl's thigh and crushed her thigh. Wow. And I've never heard anyone scream like that before. Rightfully so, because this is an animal that's able to crush lobsters or conchs, with its jaw muscles and just swallow that stuff whole. So it's certainly got quite the beak on it.
Imagine all that. I mean, just the skin to get through, just to get to the feet.
Yeah, but it's and that was the thing. It didn't break the skin. It just crushed her leg. But it's not a vicious animal by any means.
No.
If you were in the water diving with it, it wouldn't try to hurt you or anything like that. It would most certainly be more afraid of you than you are of it. It's a big turtle. But you know, she felt like her life was threatened.
See that belly coming out the side.
And of course, this is exhausting. I mean, you can imagine the whole process of pulling your body out of the water and going through all of this to where, you know, she'll get tired and stop and rest. No, not with flash, but of course, yeah. So that way we can all use our red lights and stuff like that when she's going back in. And not even, I mean, there's a big debate, and I mentioned this in our Facebook wall when we were talking about comments. There's a big debate about flash, because biologists will use flash because we need to take pictures of the turtles, and when you take a picture of something at night, you use flash. There's a big debate about whether the turtle even knows what a flash is, which of course it doesn't. It thinks it has no idea of the difference between a flash and a lightning strike.
Right.
But in the law, talking about protecting sea turtles, using a flash is illegal, and it's specifically listed. So, though using a flash isn't upsetting the turtle per se, it is breaking the law technically, so we can't use flash.
Makes sense.
So what they were talking about with this whole body pit business, the turtle comes out of the water, it finds a good spot, it kind of starts to wiggle itself down into the sand, it uses its front flippers and kind of carves out this horseshoe shape called a body pit, and then it starts digging its egg chamber and then lays eggs. So now the same thing's going on in reverse. She's wiggling around, she's caving in the walls of her body pit, which is the sand that she's built up. And now she's gathering it with her flippers and pounding it down. And whenever she senses that her body is kind of on the same level to where she's done a good job not leaving a big indentation in the sand, at least where the egg chamber is, she'll then use her front flippers, cave in the edges up here, and then she'll go on back.
Spurts of rain we had didn't disturb or stop them from coming up.
Now this may seem like it's taking a while, but I promise it's not, because a green sea turtle can take over 4 hours to do its whole nesting process.
Really?
Yep. This turtle can take, I don't know, 40 minutes.
It's actually quick for what I've seen.
No.
When are we going to start getting sand kicked in our face? When are we going to start getting sand kicked in our face?
Soon. It's starting to get level. She's going to start kicking this stuff soon.
I mean, I can't take that. I can't.
Yeah, she's starting to get there.
Yep. You'll also notice how dark it is out here because this is one of the beaches in Florida where they do everything they can to put strict regulations as possible to make sure that there are no lights facing the beach. Because what happens when the babies hatch, if they hatch at night, they instinctually go away from the darkest thing. So if they're going away from the darkest thing and you have lights on up in the dunes, the darkest thing becomes the ocean, where the darkest thing normally would be the dune line. So they would then head into the ocean. And I've heard horror stories, though I've never seen it myself, but I've heard terrible things about turtles, hatchlings, whole nests full of hatchlings winding up in parking lots and going off into the road and getting run over and all kinds of terrible things like that.
It's all when we were kids at New Smyrna.
It's terrible.
There goes the flipper.
Here we go. Here come the front flippers.
Now, you were talking, I haven't had the opportunity to really study it. Because I didn't really notice that much difference between
the crawls
coming in between the two crawls, but you noted that was right away back there was a green seed.
Yeah, it's because the greens are so much larger. Yeah. When they pull themselves up, they kind of have
it's both closer dig together in for
precisely. And when we walk back, or when we see her go down, I'll point it out to you, and then when we go walk back past that green, I'll show you in her track too.
I mean, it's easy to see the crawl, but to distinguish the species by the crawl, I've never done that.
It's almost like she's a shoe. Nobody wants a shoe picture.
See, you're going to show you.
Yeah, she's a beautiful turtle.
She's gathering.
They should be trying to separate the two groups.
Almost. I mean, as soon as she turns around, we'll know.
Right. Yeah.
She's getting ready.
Like 5 big steps back. And once she's done, it's not
But this is great. This is what you call a successful nesting. I mean, and this is something that's happened for millions and millions and millions of years. And loggerhead sea turtles are one of the older species of sea turtles from genetic research and also from just what we know about how long a species has been around. An average species is about 2 million years old. And loggerheads are a little older than that, just from fossil evidence and things like that. But of course, turtles as a group are hundreds of millions of years old. But even though they're ancient creatures, not the same species and types of turtles have been around that long. Powerful flippers. I've seen them break people's ribs before when we'll go and rescue the animals that are hit by a boat, or when we're lifting them out of tanks after they've been nursed back to health and we're bringing them somewhere to release them. The animal will be flapping and flapping and flapping while we take it out, and it can do some damage.
That was lightning.
Yeah, that was lightning.
Yeah, see, I mean, there's really no way the turtle would be able to discern lightning from a camera.
Yeah, but if you got like 10 people using flash, it's kind of.
Oh my god,
well, she's getting ready to really start turning around here, so if you want to, we can walk up to the side and you guys can take a look at her face. If you want to do that.
Sure.
good. It's such a beautiful one.
You got the hair
Yeah, it's a big turtle, all right.
Should you back up or come on that side? Like, should you back up or come on that side?
No, no, it's fine. You all can stay over there. I mean, she's getting, she should be almost ready to go.
Yeah.
She's just doing her best to hide her body here.
I like turtles.
And for her babies that hatch that are males, when they go back into the ocean, or when they go into the ocean for the first time, the males that go out in there, that'll be the last time they ever touch land crawling down this beach, unless they lay on the seafloor bottom. Only the females come back up and come in contact with the beach.
What is
this
attraction to that?
Couple of months. August. Let's see, we're in the middle of July now, so we're looking at September, end of September, very early October.
When the water's warmest.
Oh yeah, she's exhausted.
She just gave birth, man. It's her equivalent. Deserve some wine and some chocolate.
Like anyone can make a
coffee.
Just watch it.
Well, she keeps eating the same. She doesn't just do it.
That's a good question, and we have no idea. We are only, people are really only collecting that data for the first time in the last 20, maybe 30 years maximum of seeing, I mean, this is still only one generation of turtles. We don't even know for sure how long these animals live.
Yeah.
We would assume being turtles that get to this size, certainly over 50, they think that a turtle doesn't even reach this size until it's in its 20s.
So pretty much they spend their nursery years in the Sargasso Sea.
Yeah, that's what we're finding.
What about all those gyres around the coaches, I think there's what, five of them now? Does that have any effect on
them? Well, it depends on...
I mean, everything in the ocean.
Well, yes. I mean, the babies certainly have some level of navigation.
But we're unsure of whether or not a baby that is hatched in a hatchery for conservation, like if we were immediately to dig up this nest after she's gone, take the eggs before the polarity in the eggs set,